Hallelujah, friends. Good morning. It's a Wednesday, a great day already. And I believe in God that every conflict and self-government situation in our life, we are already making amendments. And I believe in God this morning, Wednesday, that God will speak to us. Father, we are grateful because your love always finds us out. Your love always restores us. For you so love us, you gave your best. This morning, Daddy, speak to us again. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Friends, this morning, I'm talking about realization. Do you know that the Bible says, 8:32, John 8:32, you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. A lot of people are where they are now because they don't realize. Sometimes people know that there's something wrong, but they've not sat down to think it out. They've not sat down to reason it out. But in Daniel chapter 4 that I mentioned yesterday, if you read from verse 1, which I want to read, Nebuchadnezzar the king unto all people, nations and language that dwell in the earth and all the earth, peace be multiplied unto you. I thought it good. A man of experience. That's why someone says it's better to learn from other people's mistake than learn from your own mistake. Because learning from your own mistake is painful. And that's why it's good for us to have mentors, for us to have leaders that we will relate with. Somebody said your leader might not be as successful as you are, but he has what you don't have, and that thing is called experience. Someone said experience is the best teacher. Someone said no, it's not the best teacher. See, experience is the best impression. Because if you put your hand into fire, sometimes you can't explain it to somebody else what you experienced. So it's the best impression to lay up on any argument. If you tell a child, don't go into fire, the child says, what's the big deal, Papa? After that fire experience, the child will not need to be told the next time. The king said, I thought it wise. I thought it good to show you signs and wonder that the eye beside God wrought towards me. A king that was king and became an animal, and for 7 years, nobody sat on his throne. Nobody contested to sit on his throne. That's Almighty God. That's the only one that can do it. And that's why many people, their destiny is still preserved. Because God had made the destiny for them. Until they close the door themselves, God will not replace them. But it's good to realize. It's good to learn from other people's experience and not fall into it before you change. The prodigal son said in chapter 17, Luke 15 and 17 to 19. The Bible said he came to himself. He said, what is this nonsense? Am I suffering here? Even servants in my father's house have food to eat. How can I now be suffering? He said, I will go back to my father. Brethren, whatever is your challenge now, I'd like you to retrace your step. Nebuchadnezzar did not have the chance like many of us are having now. The prodigal son did not understand what we are hearing now. A walk with God is security for our destiny. A walk with God is the preservation of our life and our peace of mind. A submission to Almighty God will keep you from burning your fingers in the fire of life. I conclude. In the same Daniel 4, from verse 34, the Nebuchadnezzar said something very experiential. He said, thank you, Jesus. And at the end of the days, I, the Nebuchadnezzar, lift up my eyes unto heaven. My understanding returned to me. And I bless the Most High God, and I praise and honor him that liveth forever, whose dominion is everlasting dominion. And his kingdom is from generation to generation. He lifted up his eyes to heaven, to the Most High. Beloved brethren, you need to do a lift satisfaction of your life, away from all the challenges, and realize that you need God in your equation. Think about this and make amendments. And if you have not given your life to Jesus, you need to realize, for God so loved you that He gave Jesus to sacrifice Himself for your losses, to redeem you back to God. Beloved brethren, I'll see you tomorrow morning. Have a great day. God bless you.